take you on a tide pool tour at Scripps. My name is Olivia, and I'm a PhD student here.
Hi, I'm Danny, and I'm also a PhD student here.
Hi, everyone. I'm Anae Novoa, and I'm also a PhD student here.
Hi, I'm Kayla Wilson. I'm a fifth year PhD student here.
So here we're looking at a Pisaster sea star, and they're really cool because they're called keystone species. It's also really cool to see this one right here and that big because we thought they were disappearing from the Scripps tide pool, so it's actually a really great sighting.
Yeah, there you go, that's a good crab.
Some of these hermit crabs are quite specialized to use certain snails. This is the blue-banded hermit crab. It is notorious for using tegula snail shells.
This is a Spanish shawl nudibranch, which is a type of sea slug. Sea slugs are notorious for stealing the defenses of food it eats.
So for seaweeds, you typically have like greens, reds, and browns. This is a brown seaweed, one of my favorites. This one is called the feather boa kelp, is the nickname or common name. The holdfast is down here, and if you look, the holdfast has like little finger-like projections, and its like goal pretty much is to hold on for dear life so it doesn't get swept away.
This is a combination of gooseneck barnacles and California mussels. So in combination with the rocks, these guys can help to sort of break up some of the impact of larger waves. And they're both filter feeders, so they're really good at pumping water in and out of their bodies and sort of taking all the edible items out of that water.
We're looking here, it's the Sandcastle worm, and you can see that it's a polychaete, it's a worm that creates these tubes, and they live inside the tube, and there's a lot of animals that can live within the tube as well.
They're very territorial and they'll start gurgling a lot.
So here we're looking at a sea hare, also known as the brown sea hare, the California sea hare, and it's like filling around for food. It takes these orotunicles and like touches rocks and seaweed around it to find things to eat and what's around it.
So this right here, the light orange, is an ascidian or a sea squirt. And then this stuff right here, that's a sea sponge. That's some sort of encrusting sea sponge.
So chitons are mollusks, which is pretty funny because when you look at them, you don't think they are. And what's really cool about them is that they make these depressions in the rocks, and then at night they go out to feed, and during the day they go back to their own depressions to stay there during the day.
When you're grabbing an organism, make sure that you have a little cup of water for them. These organisms are typically inundated, so which means they're typically full under the water.
You always want to make sure you're careful about where you're stepping. Always look before you step and try not to step on anything that might be disturbed, like anemones or barnacles or mussels. And always be sure to like check to make sure you're not going to step on something sharp or unstable so you don't hurt yourself.
These rock here is covered in sea anemones. You don't think so because they're actually holding shells above them.
Don't be afraid to like bend down and really like get in the crevices to look for these organisms. A lot of the times they're like hiding in these crevices because that's where they feel safe and it's very moist with lots of water. So you need to get down on all fours and just really bend and like take a good peek in where you're looking because something might be hiding there that's really cool.